الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. There is a brothers, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our salah. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث صحيح ابتسامتك في وجه أخيك صدقة. When you see your brother in Islam, you salute him with تحية الإسلام, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته, and you give him that beautiful smile, that's kind of صدقة. It's kind of صدقة, صلى الله عليه وسلم said. Imagine that Islam with the law of Allah, big law system, and Islam did not neglect that kind of small thing. What? إلا أن تلقى أخيك بوجه طلق. Subhanallah, just when you see your brother, give him a smile. And you see, I make like 7 lectures in my YouTube channel about ضحك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. That incident happened with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to make that smile or laughter. He used to laugh, صلى الله عليه وسلم. Somebody may be saying, Islam, no, you have to be serious. لا, يقول لك يعني you have to be serious, لازم تكون لبق ولازم تكون يعني مؤدب قوي يعني. Or you have to be gentle so much, or you have to be like serious. I'm not saying gentle, no, serious so much. This is not in Islam. To be serious 24/7 like that, we are not machines, we are human beings. That's why Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم after Salat al-Fajr he used to pray like this time. Sometimes, not sometimes, all the time he used to sit until the sunrise. During that time between Salat al-Fajr and sunrise, they used to make zikr, he used to teach the Sahaba, he used to preach to them. And some of them, he used to say, Ya Rasulullah, I remember something from my time of Jahiliyyah. And Rasulullah say, what did you remember? He said, Ya Rasulullah, that happened to me. And he's trying to make a joke, that Sahabi. And you know, when they remember the Jahiliyyah time, they used to make something unbelievable, something crazy during their time. Like for example, Sayyidina Umar, he used to get and make some his god from a date. And he used to shape it like this and he used to keep it. When he get angry, hungry, what happened? He used to eat his god, yes. This is something, this is what they used to do. But Sahaba, they used to make the jokes, they used to talk. And the Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يمزح ولا يقول إلا حقا. Mostly, he used to say jokes, صلى الله عليه وسلم, but he used to say the truth. For example, that old lady came to him and she said, Ya Rasulullah, أيدخل الجنة عجوز? An old lady will enter Jannah? He said, no, old lady will not enter Jannah. And the lady, she was sad, very sad, and she was leaving. And he called her back, come on. Didn't you read the Quran? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّا أَنْشَأْنَاهُنَّ إِنْشَاءً فَجَعَلْنَاهُنَّ أَبْكَارًا عُرُبًا أَتْرَابًا لِأَصْحَابِ الْيَمِينِ. Lady, Allah will create you in different future. You're gonna be young in Jannah. You'll not be old. So the lady, she was giving a good smile to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And she was so happy. And he gave her that kind of joke, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One time, he was making khutbah al-Jum'ah. It was in the manbar, during the Salat al-Jum'ah, making khutbah. A Bedouin man came and said, Ya Rasulullah, we have a big drought now. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send rain. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he raised his hand. Oh Allah, give us rain, water. Actually, I don't have to say rain, it's water in Arabic. In English, you have to say water. Ma, because rain could be punishment. Yes, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, water, ma'an, ma'anatan fi, some ni'mah, abundance. So, mashallah is coming. But rain, the word rain in Quran is not good. Matar. Yeah, matar means rain. Matar is not good. It's coming with a punishment. If I would say water is better. Ask Allah to send water from the sky. We need it. And Rasulullah raised his hand. Since he just dropped his hand like that, a lot of rain, abundant. A lot of rain came. Water, mashallah. And subhanallah, that stayed 1 week. Raining 1 week because of the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Rasulullah, later, he was making, 1 week from that time, he was making khutbah al-Jum'ah. The same man said, Ya Rasulullah, ask Allah to take this away from us. Ya gharakna, Ya Rasulullah. Subhanallah, what happened? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was giving good smile and good laughter, and he raised his hand, Ya Rab, take this water away. خلاص, يقول غرقنا يا رسول الله. We'll be drowning, Ya Rasulullah, from this rain. Subhanallah. You see, nowadays, in YouTube, sometimes they put some, subhanAllah, that water in Saudi Arabia now. Did you see how, subhanAllah, it's floods. والله دي سبحان الله يعني I cannot imagine Saudi Arabia which is الربع الخالي يعني it's desert. How that rain will come? And this is what رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم saying in the hadith ستعود أرض العرب مروجا خضراء كما كانت من قبل. The land of Arabia it will be green as it was before. Where this gas comes from? It was jungles there in Saudi Arabia. It's a big land, huge. And it was just, mashallah, it was green. That's why all of these trees and that stuff, when they're done, stayed long time under the ground and see this gas and the stuff. That's why Rasulullah said in the hadith, it will go back, it will come back green like it was before. Subhanallah, see the rain now, the snow is Saudi Arabia, snow. It's Saudi Arabia, subhanallah. This is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. رسول الله used to give the smile, very important. عائشة said, رضي الله عنها, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, when she talked about his characters or characteristics, she was a wife and she knows her husband. She said, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان ضحاكا بساما. Mostly, صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to give that smile most of his life. That smile and he used to laugh. And the laughter of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم without any sound. يعني you see him laughing and you can see his teeth from the back, but without sound. See his face, mashallah, shining, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is what Allah said. This is one of the characteristics of the people of Jannah, jama'ah. Allah, look what Allah is saying. وَجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاظِرَةٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةٌ وَلَكْ وَجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاعِمَةٌ لِسَعْيِهَا رَاضِيَةٌ سبحان الله. وجوه نادرة, وجوه يومئذٍ مسفرة ضاحكة مستبشرة. Allah, this is the characteristics of the people of Jannah then. If the Quran is saying that, وجوه مسفرة, shining faces, ضاحكة, with big smile and laughter. In Jannah, this is the people of Jannah. And وجوه يومئذٍ نادرة, shining, brighting. They're going to look to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's face. For this is the characters of the people of Jannah. When you see somebody smiling, not because he's bad, not because he's a good person. He's a good person. Most of the Rasulullah used to give that joke. He said, well, for example, Jarir ibn Abdullah, one of the Sahab, he said, since I know Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he never ever frowned in my face. All the time he used to give me the same smile. All of my life, Jarir ibn Abdullah, subhanallah. He noticed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the smile. Since he used to see Jarir, he used to give him the smile, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya jama'ah, smile can fix too many problems in your life. That smile, yes, believe me, wallahi. In your work, when you smile to your boss, when you see him from far away distance, like you give him a smile in his eyes, khalas, that's it. That's it, there is no problems anymore. When you give a smile to the people, normal person will accept it from you. But if you see somebody very complicated, يعني رب, Allah created him like that, you cannot fix him. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created. You cannot fix him. Nobody can fix him. He gonna be like this until he die. But the smile, it is in Islam, it is kind of charity, it's a kind of sadaqah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he encouraged us all to give that smile. He said, وَإِذَا حَيِّيتُمْ بِتَحِيَّةٍ فَحَيُّوا بِأَحْسَنَ مِنْهَا أُرُدُّوهَا. If somebody give you a smile, give him twice a smile. But that smile must come from your heart, not plastic one. Because that plastic one, we see it a lot. Somebody, يعني, subhanAllah, is giving you a smile and he's stabbing you from your back. We don't need this. Now, that smile must come from the heart, and you have to really, you can see the honesty of that person is giving you the smile. And the mu'mineen, this is one of the sifat of the mu'mineen. They are happy. Allah will make them happy in this life, and also thereafter they will be happy and they will give that smile. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يعني, will give that tamyiz in the day of judgment. You're going to see the faces of the people of Jannah, brightening, shining, smiling, that laughter in their faces, and the people of hellfire, you're gonna see them gloomy, wal'a'azu billah, dirty. قال الله سبحانه وجوه يومئذ مسفرة ضاحكة مستبشرة. Faces in that day, some faces in that day, Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, مسفرة, brightening, shining, ضاحكة, with full of laughter, مستبشرة, they have glad tidings, good news, somebody giving news, سبحان الله. That's why Rasulullah said in the hadith, when you come to the masjid, since you entered the masjid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yatabashbash laka. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you that big smile when you come to the masjid every time. Like what? Rasulullah is giving the example. Like If you have somebody, if your relatives, 10 years you never saw him, and suddenly you see his face and you love him, what are you gonna do? Oof, man, I didn't see you 10 years. Wow, give him that good smile and big hug. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be happy more than that person. Not just that. قال الحديث حديث بسندك حديث رواه الترمذي قال يتبشبش في وجوهكم. Allah will give you that بشبش. What's that بشبش? Big smile. That's why when you finish your salah, you look at your face. Wallahi, you see that touch of the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes to your face after the salah. And you cannot get that touch except when you come to the masjid. Those who are not coming to the masajid, they will never have the touch. Even if you see somebody, mashallah, his eyes, blue eyes or green eyes, and his blonde, and they were, mashallah, beautiful, handsome, but he's not praying, he's not coming to the masjid, he's not showing his face to Allah, you cannot see the touch of light in his face. Wallahi, ya jama'ah. Noor, it's noor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving throw to you from his light. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fa ya jama'ah, tabashbush is very important. And they said in the day of judgment, these people, mashallah, the people of happiness, and wawujuhun yawma idhin, alayha ghabara. عليها غبرة ترهقها قطرة أولئك هم الكفرة الفجر. And some faces full of dirt. عليها غبرة ترهقها قطرة. They are tired. They are sad, gloomy. They have grief in their hearts. They are those who are the disbelievers. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said. ف you have to choose your way from now. Smile, give a smile as much as you can. والله يا جماعة, with our attitude as Muslims, this is what we need nowadays. If we have good manners and good akhlaq, believe me, Sheikh Nabilsi said that, I like what he said. He said to, he mentioned that story, that two students, Arab students, Muslims, they were in England studying. And they have a friend, that friend is non-Muslim. And subhanAllah, they used to speak Arabic when they used to meet each other. Since that friend comes, used to come to them, what happened? They changed to English. They said, guys, I noticed that when I'm not here, you're speaking Arabic. But since I come, you speak English. What is the reason? He said, because Rasulullah, they told him, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that hadith, إِذَا كُنْتُمْ ثَلَاثَ فَلَا يَتَنَاجَ اثْنَانَ دُونَ الثَّالِثِ. I love this. If you are three, don't let two of you whisper to each other while others, the third one is just looking. Maybe he's gonna think they are talking about him. Yes. He said, that's why. You speak Arabic when you sit together, and when I come, you speak English with me. He said, yes, that's why. And the man, he said that, your prophet said that? He said, yes, Prophet Muhammad said that. Wow. He said, your prophet was so gentleman. Wow, what is this? This is good etiquette, you know? And this is what Rasulullah told us. This is the sunnah, the challenge of sunnah. And this smile is one of the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. See, and that man 6 months, he used to study the Islam because of the Prophet Muhammad's gentleness. Because he said that. And that man, he became Muslim. See? Ya wallahi, ya jama'a, you never know. But that's why that smile can make a difference in our life. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you that smile, inshallah, on your face, and to make you happy. Ameen, ya Rabb, dunya and the akhirah. Allahumma ameen, ya Rabb al-alamin. Rabbana taqabbal minna, ya Rabb al-alamin. ربنا اغفر لنا يا ارحم الراحمين اللهم احينا سعداء وامتنا شهداء والحقنا برفقه الانبياء يا رب العالمين استرنا واجبرنا وعافينا واهدنا واشفنا يا ارحم الراحمين اللهم اكفنا شرار خلقك من الجن والانس واجعل كيدهم في نحورهم يا ارحم الراحمين اللهم يا رب من اراد بالاسلام والمسلمين سوءا فاجعل كيده في نحره يا رب العالمين اللهم استرنا وارحمنا واجبرنا وارحم المسلمين واستر المسلمين واكرم المسلمين ووحد صفوف المسلمين واغفر لابائنا ولامهاتنا كما ربنا صغيرا يا رب العالمين ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار وصلى الله على محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم جزاكم الله خيرا.